What's up, everybody, and welcome to another edition of AGR's Pop Culture Reviews. And is it me, or has YouTube lost its frickin' mind? Seriously, YouTube? YouTube heroes, give me a break, man. Now that YouTube has gone all Joseph McCarthy on us, I can't tell you how out of touch I think YouTube is with its content creators. I mean, just the mere fact that they have certain services that you can unlock which should already be there, like, I don't know, talking to a human being, is ridiculous in its own right, and I can't believe what YouTube is doing, all because of a lot of bad press that they're getting now. And you know what? I get it. You know, people are gonna do desperate things because they want to quell the populace. That's fine, but this was the wrong way to do it. It was absolutely stupid. But you know what? Regardless of the stupidity on YouTube, I don't care. Nothing is gonna quell my freaking awesome day today, because today I have my Ray. So guys, I have a really special piece for you today, something that I've been anticipating, and it seems like I anticipate a lot of things, but this one I really anticipated for a while. Today we're going to be taking a look at the movie masterpiece 1/6 scale Hot Toys version of Rey from Star Wars Episode 7, The Force Awakens. Let's take a closer look. Guys, you know how I am, and when something scares the piss out of me, particularly with a head sculpt, you know they're doing something right. Now, it's no secret that Hot Toys is really, again, on the cusp of, like, the best freaking figures that I've ever reviewed. But, my God, look at this. This is absolutely exquisite. I cannot believe how lifelike this looks. This is absolutely Daisy Ridley. The shading on the skin was just right. The eyes are magnificent. And take a look at those lips. This is perfection. Great job, Hot Toys. The attention to detail here is unbelievable, like off the charts, man. If you take a look at her skin, you see the little imperfections, the freckles. It looks like somebody who's been out in the desert for a very long time. Very reminiscent of the character, since they are on planet Jakku. But I gotta tell you, the shading here is unbelievable. She looks like she has a suntan. I also have to mention, the fabric here is unbelievable. I mean, just look at that. They used a real linen fabric. It looks fantastic. The details on her arm in particular, I mean, look, that takes time. Somebody has to individually do that to the actual fabric to get that effect. And that's why these freaking figures are so high quality. That's absolutely outstanding. I have to say, too, that, you know what, they didn't really skimp in terms of the quality of the materials. I mean, I know that this is not real leather, but it certainly feels like real leather. The detail on her straps look amazing, and I'm not a tailor, but honestly, I couldn't tell the difference between pleather and real leather. This is exquisite. You know, I've been doing these reviews for a while now, and you can certainly tell when a figure kind of cheaped out a little bit in terms of the material they used. Fortunately, that's not the case in this figure. They did a really great job in keeping that quality, and you can definitely tell in her gauntlet. The weathering was done just right, and you know what? It looks like actual fabric. Okay, here's the deal, guys. As I'm reviewing this figure, I am being more and more impressed with the level of quality here. For example, whoever stitched this pouch together deserves a raise, hands down. Look at the quality here. This is craftsmanship at its best. And this is why I think that Hot Toys is just unbeatable in terms of their 1/6 scale figures. This is amazing. Again, I have to give kudos to the fabric that was used here. It's actual linen. And look at that detail at the bottom. If you see, they frilled it up. Somebody actually had to go and do that by hand, basically. The folds look fantastic, and what I really like is that it's very lightweight, and it simulates some of the garb that somebody would use that would be out in the desert. I mean, it can't be heavy, right? This is pretty awesome, and I gotta give it to Hot Toys again, and I know that I keep basically blowing smoke up there, you know what, but this is amazing. Probably one of the most impressive things about this figure is definitely in her boots, and I'm gonna tell you right now, guys, that the video is not doing it justice. Essentially, what they've done here is they've simulated two things, not only the weathering on the boots, but also the dried out leather look, which is something that would happen in the desert. This is unbelievable in terms of the overall detail, and I'm glad that they, even at her feet, they paid this close attention to this figure. This is fantastic. To say that this figure comes with accessories is an incredible understatement, but one of the most impressive ones is definitely in her staff. The detail here is unbelievable. I like the mixed media, particularly with some of the wrappings that are found throughout the entire staff. And it's also almost the length of the entire figure, which is approximately 12 inches. give or take a few, but it's absolutely incredible in terms of the way that they actually made it, and definitely something that I'm going to display this figure with. Now, the other accessory that this figure comes with that I currently have displayed with is the blaster that was given to her by Han Solo. This is a really great piece. If you'll notice, they also did a really high polish to the finish, very similar to what we see in the film. The stock is done really well, and you know what? It's just an overall really great recreation. I really like it a lot. Now, after reviewing several Hot Toys Star Wars figures, I've come to know this style of base very well. And it's the typical Star Wars base, basically. The only difference is that this one has the Rebellion insignia. Now, it also comes with your standard crotch grabber, which is, you know, pretty ubiquitous at this point. I really wish that they would have done a little more customization with Rey, since she's a very powerful figure. The lip of the base does have the Star Wars logo. It also reads BB-8 and Rey, and we'll get to BB-8 in a minute. Overall, it's a pretty good base, and it does come with another accessory, which I'll show in a moment. Now, this addition to the base is also pretty typical of the offerings that Hot Toys gives you, and it's essentially a little bit of the terrain that they find on the various planets. Since we first meet Rey on Jakku, essentially what they gave you was a big mound of desert, or a big mound of sand, basically. Now, it's not that bad. The texturing is done really well, and I do like the detail, but it's nothing too spectacular, and I guess it's up to you to decide how you want to display it. Overall, it's pretty serviceable. So here he is, guys. This is definitely the star of the show, BB-8. Now, the cool thing is that Sideshow Collectibles sent over the bundle pack with BB-8 and Rey over for review. And guys, I highly recommend that if you want this set, you get it this way. Now, BB-8 is completely modularized, just like in the film. The top of the bottom of his head has three magnets that are kind of on a rolling ball, and there's also a switch because this BB-8 does light up, which is pretty cool. And don't worry guys, Hot Toys did include the batteries on this one. They also included a really cool internal equilibrium system so that he's not rolling all over the place, which is also pretty good. Now here we go guys, remember when I told you that this figure comes with a lot of accessories? Well, pause this and go get a bag of chips, because this is going to take a while. First, it comes with an additional backpack, which as you can see is incredibly detailed. And it also comes with some canisters, presumably for water, and various other things that keep Rey alive in the desert. And I have to say, the materials here, just like the rest of the figure, look fantastic. Now, I'll be honest with you guys, I have absolutely no idea what the hell this is. I think it's some kind of communications device or some kind of optic, but it's actually really detailed. I'm sure many of you Star Wars fans will know what this is. But you know what? It's just cool that we have it. She also comes with the additional set of clothing, and essentially what this is that deep desert garb that she's wearing. When we first meet Rey at the very beginning of the film, when she's crawling into that Star Destroyer, this is freaking awesome, and you know what, it was really hard for me to decide how to display her, whether to display her in her deep desert garb or just keep her normal. Either way, it's just nice to have. Now, I was gonna include these with the desert garb, but you know what, they're so incredible that I had to put it on its own. The level of detail on her goggles is absolutely incredible, and one of the things that I particularly like is they actually used green for the eye inlets. That's freaking awesome. I can't wait to see what this figure looks like once I put them on. And of course I saved the best for last, this very exquisite lightsaber. This thing is so detailed, it's absolutely incredible. I especially like the high polish that they finished the hilt with, and that nice deep sapphire blue for the lightsaber. I mean, it's just really, really nice. They also included the batteries for BB-8, as you can see, and like I said, it's a very quick install, but this lightsaber, above all, is just beautiful. Now, true to the overall theme of this figure and how many things that it comes with, you also get a cacophony of hands. They come both gloved and ungloved, and I gotta tell you guys, given this whole package, you're really getting a lot for your money, because it gives you endless displayability. Really great. Overall guys, this is a fantastic figure, and if you're gonna get it, I gotta tell you, please bundle it, because they look fantastic together. Now before I go, I just gotta thank the folks over at Sideshow Collectibles for sending these two wonderful pieces over for review. Alright guys, so that's my official review on the movie masterpiece, 1/6 scale, Hot Toys version of Rey and BB-8. As always, I thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you on the next AGR's Pop Culture Reviews, and may the Force be with you.